The following program contains violence, disturbing imagery, nudity, and, oh my God, why are you even watching this? Just run away. This shit is going to give you nightmares. For real. Nightmares where you are running naked on a treadmill made of razor blades, and your third grade teacher is pointing and laughing at you. And even if you survive the treadmill with your feet intact, she is going to tell you that you flunked the third grade, which negates all the rest of your achievements. The program is rated TV-MA-NSFW, OMFG, GAF-TTV-BYGAS. It is unsafe for epileptics. It kills lab rats. Why are you still here? This show came out of the dark recesses of a coked-up guy's mind who has just been given too much privilege and access and now just takes a depraved delight in disturbing and scaring you. In fact, if we're being totally honest here, the original creator never expected a third season pickup, so now he's just trying to think of creative ways to kill the characters off. Seriously, don't watch this. We can't warn you strongly enough. Do you need a doctor of some kind? What is the matter with you?
From Atlantic City, New Jersey, weighing 458 pounds, King Kong Bundy!
Six foot six, 455 pounds, the biggest man in professional wrestling,
King Kong Bundy, from down south in Atlantic City. Beautiful, beautiful city, by the way. Just a second here, you fill up the screen pretty well.
I can fill up two screens! Go ahead, introduce me.
Mr. Bundy, how are you?
You are demanding of officials throughout the World Wrestling Federation not for a three count, but a five count.
The only man in the history of professional wrestling to demand a five count, Gene. When Bundy puts you down and the referee counts to five, then there's no doubt in anybody's mind you've been beat. You're not talking about a man 300 pounds. You're not talking about a man 350 pounds. You're talking about 458 pounds. And I'm going to shut up when I'm talking to you, little runt.
We are back here once again live on WWA programming, getting down to the nitty gritty. Obviously, Chris Morales had a lot to say about me on the last episode. He wanted to flap his gums and run his mouth and try to make fun of Kevin Impact, which if there's one thing to learn in this business is that Kevin Impact is not the one to go after. So, if you don't know that, obviously Chris Morales didn't listen to the Kevin Impact statement. Speaking of statement, I like to show Chris Morales how I get down, since he wanted to show me how he got down. And I like to officially announce that I've been deemed the 100% sole general manager of WWA wrestling programming. That means that I have the cojones, the ability, the power, the pull, the strength. I'm the hombre and the head honcho. 100% general manager. I am in full control of everything and anything that happens in WWA TV. So with that being said, as my first official act as general manager, I said that Chris Morales' days were numbered. I said that Chris Morales, I was going to take care of. And now, little pig, let me in. Because Chris Morales, you're fired. As anything with GM, that is, WWE-wise. We want to keep you around, Chris. I got some plans for you, kid. Just stay tuned. That's the first executive decision that I'm making as the new general manager of WWE. Now, on to other things here. So I just want to make it clear that I'm the general manager of Shockwave and Haywire all together. And again, we're going to be making big decisions for this company moving forward. Now, from my understanding, we have a pay-per-view coming up titled Heir to the Throne. Now, you got Trey Jeter, you got Devontae Wright, you got Corey Flash, you got that boy Michael Blaze. Well, I like to say that I'm going to change some things up. What I've decided instead is that at Heir to the Throne, the match to see now is going to be for the Power Championship, and it is going to be King Wolf one-on-one with Mr. Amazing. That is going to be the match that is going to be taking place at Heir to the Throne. With all that being said, I like to take this time to pay homage and give recognition to the late great King Kong Bundy, one of the all-time greats in pro wrestling, certainly a man who was influential in my development as Kevin Impact and as a man and as a wrestling fan. Obviously, us here at WWA recognize this symbolic character in the history of pro wrestling and would like to highlight him and recognize him here tonight, this evening at this event. I also want to throw my hat in there, or my AVs in there, with a top that, and I'd like to also bring recognition to the late great Mean Gene Oakland at that, Luke Perry, and also that boy right there, an inspiration to me. I was going to say Chris Morales. Obviously, Chris Morales wouldn't be here. I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for Pedro Morales, but Pedro Morales also throw his name in the hat. I want to thank all you folks for watching this show here. It's going to keep getting good. Keep on watching, like, comment, subscribe, and share. And top that.
Chair. He breaks the lift in the face! What the hell was that? Oh my gosh, he sprays the mist in her face. Oh my god. She had insult to injury with that one. Oh my god. Caught her slipping. Boom! Caught her slipping with that one. One, two,
a competitor
three.
Has been eliminated.
We'll go in the face of Alexis.
Yeah.
Rodriguez.
Yeah, look, you got to go. Like he's a charging cat. Like I got a baby and he did that. Like my boyfriend cheated on me, but I ran off with his stash. Like I lost
my
God,
but
I got to keep my ass. I just woke up like Yancey. Had a two gigante. This ain't no comprante. Size elefante. This is on a holiday. Haters wake up. Better preach it like a Aretha. Pray before your makeup. I got these bitches kind of dripping on my
fucking skin.
Yeah, they stole my style, but I still made a couple million. Yeah, they got me fucked up. It's cool, bro. I'm chilling. I just
want to copy.
Here is your winner, the Queen, Teresa Lopez.
Wow, ladies and gentlemen, that was a good opening match, to be honest. I'm gonna tell you that now. And here it comes.
Making his way to the ring from Denver, Colorado, weighing in at 240 pounds, the World Wrestling All-Star Champion. Antonio Black Rose King Champion.
Thank you, JoJo, for that introduction right there. And there it is. Main event is something special. The Bruiser is teaming with a Mr. Theory tag team partner from the Nusa Club after the Nusa Club jumped him on the last haywire.
And his opponent from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, weighing in at 221 pounds, the World Wrestling All-Star Hardcore Champion, Blake Andrews, champion.
Antonio King, Blake Andrews. Oh, they both went for the same move. Ooh.
good for his career. Oh, kick. Oh, knee to the face. Oh. Oh, damn. The knee and the kick. This is why he's WWE. Oh, that judo toss. That's why he's your WWE champion. And a people's elbow. Oh, the knee lift. WWE champion showing why he is the WWE champion. Oh, the Blazer showing why he's the hardcore champ. He's rolling out the ring. Ref is counting.
Two.
Oh. Oh, caught him.
Three.
And. Oh, caught him again. Champion's getting a little cocky right now.
Seven.
Tell him to come on.
Eight.
Oh! What a DDT right there. Clothesline. WWE champion. To show why he is the best at what he does here. Oh! Putting the hardcore champion down. Oh, he caught him. God, that was out of nowhere. Oh! is deadly.
God, what's the, it's Flash. Flash and Trey? Oh my God. Trey just punched Flash. Oh my, Flash is punching Trey. They both are supposed to be scheduled to be at ringside tonight. Flash with Newsom Club and Trey with the Bruiser, but I don't know what's going on. Look at this. They're going at it backstage. Oh my God. Ooh, oh my God. Oh my God, Flash and Trey are going at it. Oh. 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 Flash is throwing Trey down the hallway. Oh my God! What a danger zone shoot to the face of Flash. Oh my God, Trey. Super kick! The Flash! And I didn't mention Flash has a match next Shockwave, I'm sorry. Against Jeffrey Albritton. For a number one contendership for Beat the Clock Championship. Oh my God! Oh my God! Trey just super kick Flash. Flash is trying to take Trey out of the equation. Oh my God. Oh, Flash caught Trey. Trey's got Flash. What is going on here, people? Oh, and Trey's going down the hall again. Oh, the super kick. He's going into the boss's office. Flash is following Trey. Oh my God. Oh my God. What is going on? He's putting them against the table. Oh my God. Flash got knocked out with a super kick.
The name's Michael, but you can call me Teflon. I was dropped on my head at an early age. They say I'm brain damaged. They say I'm a wild man, fearless and unpredictable. I won't live to see 40, but ain't none of that gonna hold me back.
Name's John, but you can call me Milwaukee. I ain't afraid to get caged, and I damn sure ain't afraid to gamble my life for the almighty dollar. That's me up front. I'm sure Connor isn't too far behind.
Name's O'Connor. Now I hate these punks. If you decide to break the rules on my road, I'll put you away for life. If you want to be a wise guy, I'll kick your teeth in myself. And it's all self-defense. It's end of the line, losers. Made me run over a squirrel. Now I got blood on my new bike. Make sure you scumbags never ride a bike ever again.
Not if I can help it.
Hey, man, I'll tell you what. You know, there's a lot of things going on in here in WWE. Some people say that the deck has been stacked a little too heavy on one show over the other. So I want to tell you what, Trey. Since things are kind of heavy on Shockwave with the talent pool, give this little contract right here. We're going to offer you a contract to come to WWE Haywire. So here it is right here. Think it through. Have your attorney get back to me and top that, amigo.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. And something happened backstage that was not expected. Flash showed up and he went after Trey Jeter. And now we got Princess. You heard JoJo, the debut of Princess P is here. Here in WWA. So this should be, you know, kind of cool. Kind of good. Let's see how this works out. But, and she's going against another one. Well, no, I think she debuted on Shockwave, I think, if I remember correctly. Her name
and her opponent from Ozone Park, New York.
Tiffany Taylor, we did debut on the last episode of Shockwave. So yeah, that should be cool. So this should be really good to see how this is going to shape up between Princess P and Tiffany Taylor. Tiffany Taylor got the win last time. So let's see how this works out. As you see, Miss Taylor has a mirror. I just think she's all that. Princess P, Tiffany Taylor. And here we go. Oh, the clothesline from Princess P. Oh, Princess P at the gate is coming in with some good awesomeness right there. Oh. Oh. That had to hurt. Those combinations of kicks had to hurt. I'm just saying. Clothesline from Tiffany. Nope. Look at this. Ooh, Princess P. Tiffany is a little bit taller than Princess P. Oh, but Princess P is just laying Tiffany out with that, the boot to the face. Ooh, that was a good boot, I'm not gonna lie. Oh! Across the throat of Tiffany Taylor, Princess P. Oh, and Princess P has the back. Let's see. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, Tiffany's trying to make it early in early here. With that little submission, Princess P is like, you thought. Ooh. Oh. Oh! Oh, look at that there. Princess P. guy across the throat. He's kicking people's faces off, Princess P. Uh-oh. Look at this. Yeah! Princess P, are you picking up her first victory here? One, two. Ooh, kick out at 2 3/4. Colt. Told her again. This is P got that knockdown. And she popped right back up like a little jackrabbit. I don't know what she's going for here. She's going to try to... Ooh, look at that. That was something else right there. She's going for the pin. One. Oh, kick out at one from Princess P to Tiffany Taylor. Well, she's going to try to do it again. Oh, no, Princess P said, like, no, you thought. Ooh, dropped her on like that. Oh, super kick to the face. Uh-oh. Princess P! Yaga! Got it! Go for the pin! One, two, three! And there's your winner, Princess P! That was a good match. That was a good debut match for Princess P. That was pretty good. Ooh. You know, Tiffany almost came out with the win there at one point. And what? But no, kick out. And Princess P was like, you thought. Yeah! And here's your winner. Princess P that came out on top in her debut match against Tiffany Taylor. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let's get on to our main event of the evening. It's going to be one hell of a match. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your co-main event of the evening. We got...
The following contest is a no disqualifications match. Making his way to the ring from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Weighing in at 235 pounds, Drew Adams.
You heard it. There goes the future of flight himself, Mr. Drew freaking Adams. And he's taking on the power champion, King Wolf, in our co-main event of the evening. So, this is really a good match here, you know. See how this one rock and rolls with the Isotolas.
You heard from K.I., Mr. Impact, earlier tonight on the top of the show, talking about how King Boom's going to defend the Power Championship against Drew, against Mr. Amazing, Devontae Wright, at Heir to the Throne. So that should be a really good match, people. And speaking of King Wolf, speaking of the Painkiller, here he comes. Alright, what the hell is up with all the darkness, people? Well then, King Wolf has complete and total darkness. That is, the Painkiller is here. And he is the Power Champion. The Power Championship represents WWA, S&W, JTV, and of course, the Painkiller's home turf, Danger Zone Wrestling. So we have our Power Champion right here in front of everybody. Look at the Power Championship. That is awesome. And Wolf is like, he's gonna bring the power, he's gonna bring the pain to Mr. Amazing at Heir to the Throne. But hey, let's get into this match. Should be a good one. Oh yeah, let's get it. Your co-main event of the evening, King Wolf versus Drew. Oh, Wolf runs into the ring, runs straight into action with a knee to the face to Drew Adams. Oh, he's sliding. Oh, King Wolf brings him down. Oh, caught him. He rolls out the ring. Wolf moved to the side and he missed on the floor, almost hitting the steel steps. Throw him into the barricade. Oh! Into the crowd. They're going into the crowd. This is a 20 count. No disqualifications. Oh, he's just pummeling them. Oh! Caught him. Oh! Oh, they just punching each other. Wolf. Drew is trying to run away from Wolf. Oh! Count of 11. And Drew's up at the count of 13. Oh, caught him. Drew got out of that submission. Oh, he kicks him in the back. Look at this. Boom, spikes him. Oh, he went for the diving and then Wolf came back into the ring. Wolf! Oh, the Painkiller. Painkiller's going up top.
What was that? Oh, Wolf. Oh, Wolf plants him. And Drew's just trying to get up. Oh, elbow to the back of the head. Look at this. Oh, another. Just planting him. Wolf is just doing it, trying to make him submit. But no, Drew gets out of that quick. Wolf! Oh! And Wolf! Oh, punch, 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 punch! To the face of Drew Adams. It's shocking to see Drew Adams like in this predicament. Oh my God. Picks him up. Nope. Oh, and Wolf drops him. One. Two. Ooh. We'll say he's not done with Drew yet. Oh. Punches. This is the repeated punches to the face of Drew Adams. He's trying to make him submit. That's what it looks like he's trying to do. But Drew is like, you fought. Yaga. Oh, just to the gut. Caught him again. And Wolf, oh, to the back of the neck. One, two, three, and King Wolf comes out the victor. King Wolf. King Wolf, the power champion, came out on top. Once again, the king is on top of the world. Let's see how this is gonna. But Wolf is gonna go on to face a certain face, Mr. Amazing. So let's get up to our main event of the evening, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, we have our main event of the evening. Our co-main event was King Wolf versus Drew Adams, and King Wolf came out on top on that one.
Team match. I don't know. Introducing first, from Miami, Florida, weighing in at 230 pounds, the Bruiser.
And I'm your lowly commentator of the Black Italian Stallion, that is Vincent Del Pino. And we got ourselves a great main event here. We got the Bruiser, but he's taking on the Newsom Club, but we don't know who his partner is. Yeah, it's like we don't know. That's a confusing thing. We're like, he tweeted that someone was going to return tonight, but I don't know who it could be, so we're going to see who is his partner. Here tonight.
We're all anxious to find out who the Bruiser's tag team partner could be. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we have three more episodes until Heir to the Throne, because we are on the road to Heir to the Throne right now. God, this is exciting. This is new. It's about to be lit, fam. I'm telling y'all, this is about to be cool. Woo! But, you know, we'll see. Wait. I know that song. No! I thought he had retired. But oh. There he is! That's the Samoan Animal! The Samoan Animal, Jason Kawhi, is here, baby. Woo! This is finna get good, baby. Jason Kawhi is here. It looks like the Bruiser sent him some gear. And they are here to take on the Newsome Club, baby. Oh, this finna be good. Oh, I've been wanting to see a Jay Driller for a minute, baby. Oh, this is going to be good. The Bruiser and Jason Kawhi, baby. Oh, my God. This is finna be a good match. This is finna be a hell of a match, baby. Woo! And they're finna take on the Newsome Club.
And their opponent, at a combined weight of 468 pounds, Andy News One and Bullet Tom.
Andy Newsome and Bullet Tom. Andy Newsome and Bullet Tom, the Newsome Club. They are coming down to the ring, baby. They're ready to have, they're ready to rock and roll it with the Isotolas. The Newsome Club is very, it seems like Flash didn't show up with them. Viper didn't show up and Trey obviously didn't show up, so it should be good. The Bruiser, Kawhi, versus the Newsome Club. Oh, the clothesline from the Bruiser. He's already starting off. Oh, and Andy Newsome. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Oh. You got Andy Newsome in the corner. Snake Eyes! And drops Andy Newsome. Ooh, threw him in the corner. Uh-oh, he's throwing him into the Newsome Club territory over there. What is he? Uh-oh. Oh! And the Bruiser. Oh, and Andy Newsome. Uh-oh. Oh. Going for a double team there with his cousin. But no!
Oh, and he brings him down. Throws him back in the corner. Oh, he tags him in. Oh, my God. The power. Oh, the speed. That's one of the most underestimated things about Jason is his power and his speed and his agility. Look at it. Oh! Here we go. Oh! Brings him down with authority. Uh-oh. Beast Mode. Oh, my God! Ooh, reverse it. Ooh, throws him into the corner. Oh, he hits bullet time. Ooh. Uh-oh, Andy. Oh. Oh. Uh-oh. Kawhi Legacy. He's the only one of the family that still uses it. He's going up top. It's rare to see him go up top, but when he does, oh, you better watch out, because he's coming down hard. Oh, clothesline. Oh, Andy. Andy got him. Then bullet time is tagged in. Oh! Came with an elbow right there. He's trying to make him tap out right there. But nope! He gets out! Uh-oh! Oh my God! He just demolish him with that. Throws him to the corner. Another double team. Oh! Drops him. Ooh, caught him. Here we go. Elb knee to the chest of bullet time. Bullet time rolls out. Ooh. Bullet time. Uh-oh. Oh, he reverses his law. He's about to go for Kawhi Legacy, but he reverses it. Nope. Tried to come in. He got caught. Oh! Float over! Nope. Caught him again. Caught him. Oh! DDT! Uh-oh. Final destination! The Bruiser hit bullet time with a final destination, but there's no time to get cocky, bruv. Clothesline. Going for the pin. One, two, kick out at two. Ooh, wrenching that neck. He's wrenching the neck of bullet time right there. Oh my God. Tags in Jason. That's not good. Uh-oh. Kawhi Legacy! Bow! Uh-oh.
Here we go. Jay Drilla. Oh my God. He's going for it again. He's going for it again. Here we go. Jay Drilla. Going for the pin. One, two, three, and Bullet Tom has been eliminated. Jason is getting rowdied up. He's tethered in, tagging his cousin, because his cousin's about to fly. There goes a flying Kawhi. Ooh, and Andy reverses. Andy, ooh. That is not soft right there. That is very thin padding. Oh, and a DDT to the Bruiser. The Bruiser runs to the ring right now. And a DDT. Oh, and a clothesline from Andy Newsom to the Bruiser. Oh, Andy Newsom. He's going for the pin. One. Oh. He's going. Oh, the clothesline from the Bruiser. Bruiser's got him up. Kawhi Legacy. He's going for the inspiration of his one of his favorite Samoan wrestlers, The Rock. And he's going for the pin. One. Two. Oh, and Andy Newsom kicks out at two. Well, then that made the Bruiser angry that he kicked out of that. Ooh. Look at this. Andy Newsom. Oh. Oh! Andy Newsom! Oh! Andy Newsom! Oh! Oh! Andy Newsom's like, I'm not about to take this, boy. Andy Newsom's just rolling with it. But my question is, can you imagine having the Bruiser and Trey Jeter on the same brand? Because if you didn't know, earlier tonight, kept WWE General Manager, not Haywire, not Shockwaves, but WWE General Manager Kevin Impact offered Trey Jeter a contract, and the Bruiser was there for it. He was checking on him after him and Flash got into an altercation backstage. Oh, and a clothesline from Andy Newsom. Oh, and a backbreaker from Andy Newsom. Look at this. Ooh. Final Destination. Now, he's gonna end it with the Bruiser. Oh, the Bruiser. Oh! Stomp to the chest. And from my understanding, Jason is only here
for tonight. This is a one-time deal. This is a one-time shot. And after this, he's going back into retirement. He wants Andy to turn around. He's taunting. He's showing off for the crowd. And that may have just, oh! So that may have just cost him. Oh, the stomp. That's just the vicious stomps from Andy Newsom. Look at this. He's doing the same thing he did with the Bruiser. He's rolling. He's got him in that death clutch right there. This is not gonna be good. Ooh, big shoulder tackle right there. Pulling back into the ring. I think I know what he's trying to do. Dang it. I know what he's trying to do, and it messed him up, and he messed up. And boom! He's going to hit him with that J-driller. It ended. I thought he was going to end it with that J-driller, but I guess not. Oh! That clothesline. Beast bomb. Jason. Oh, and Andy Newsom. She went for a super kick right there. And, oh, he's breaking his leg right there. Andy Newsom. Oh, oh, oh. Uh-oh. That's it. He's out. Jason is out after that. And the Bruiser is not happy right now. And, oh, he's going for that. The turnbuckles again. And Jason has finally had enough of that. Break his arm. Oh. Ooh. Got the Bruiser. Backbreaker. Oh my God. He caught him. Oh my God, he caught him. Got him. Legacy Kawhi. One, two, three.
A competitor has been eliminated.
And the Bruiser and Jason Kawhi come out the victors. Jason has a little bit of ring rust, but not much. Look at this. Wow!
Here are your winners, the Bruiser and the Animal, Jason Kaplan.
Cousins teaming together for the first time in over 4.5 years. And Jason came back for one more match because his cousin asked him to come back. And we'll see him at the retirement ceremony. I've been your host, the Black Attack, David Del Pino. And ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us here on WWE Haywire. And we'll see you on Shockwave. So let me break it all down.